Auburn, thank you for sending us the video. We so wish we could be doing this live, and next year, please consider coming to our festival because it's so interactive. I think you'd have a great time. You get to watch some other groups, but what we do is you'll work on stage, and then there's two or three of us that will come on stage and work with you, and then send you to another room with more great people to keep working the show. And we've got workshops and other things that happen during our festival, so come live next year. We'll work even more. But it's such a weird year, obviously, for show choir, and it's just nice to see that you put together a show. I know there are schools where kids chose not to do show choir because there's no competitions. I don't know if that was the case with your group, but just know and be proud of the fact that you put together a show. You're getting better as performers because you're doing it, and I hope that you're learning and growing together and enjoying the process too, because that's super important. So I like the musical numbers that you did, and I'm going to just talk about some overall things, and then we'll dig into the songs a little bit, and then Dan will follow up with some things too. But again, congrats for learning and growing. Pluses in this show, you just got some really good performers in this group, great soloist, and I think the choreography design is really appropriate and works well for what you're trying to do. Some issues that I'm going to mention a few times in each of the songs, there's spacing issues that we can talk about in terms of how you've got people arranged on stage, and then also just 100% individual effort and ability to do the choreography. Now that said, there wasn't anybody on stage that I thought, oh man, that kid's never gonna learn the choreography. But there were some who were more comfortable with choreography than others, and that's typical of all show choirs at some point. Then it's up to you as an individual to get to the point where you've practiced enough, maybe spent some time on some individual moves yourself so that you can recreate that choreography without having to think about it too much and really bring the style and the attitude, which is the next thing we'll talk about. So anyway, first song, Faith, really cool choreography. I would check the spacing on this one. You've got the guys in the middle, and then I would make sure that the girls on both sides look pretty symmetrical in terms of angled down and away from the guys. It looked like the one side there was a girl that was a little closer to center than the other. Not everything has to be symmetrical, but it always looks better, especially early on in the show. I would check the spacing on that one. Maybe there was somebody missing too, I'm not sure. I would say, just one musical thing, just terrace a little more dynamics. After you do the dance break, you can start softer and then build it. Other than that, it's really just about the attitude. See the girl with the diamonds in her shoes. I saw this attitude in some, but not everybody. Maybe we need to just perform in a circle for each other to get everybody into that mode, because that's where the choreography really takes off. You've done the choreography, you've learned it, now it's the attitude outside of that. When you get into the ballad, my gosh, what great solos. Just wonderful. I would take out all of the step snaps in that song. I don't think you need them. I think that song is powerful enough, you've got powerful enough soloists that I think eventually the step snaps started to actually kind of fall apart and get a little tired. And so either take them out or maybe start them later and don't do them for as long. Because we're a show choir, sometimes we think, oh, we got to move, we got to do something. Well, if you watch Broadway performers, a lot of times it's very simple. They're standing in a spot, they're performing the song, and you don't get bored because they're so good at it and they're so invested in the words. I think this is one of those songs where I would take the step snaps out. This is one thing about the spacing. I think the spacing just needs to be clearer in this. It seemed like there were windows, people weren't hitting windows. It looked a little random. And then when you have a situation where you have fewer guys than girls in the group, you need to really think about where the guys are placed. And so sometimes there were maybe two on one side and one somewhere else. I would make sure that that's always symmetrical with where those guys are. They don't have to be together, but be thinking about where they are in the picture, and then mix the sopranos and altos in. And even if you have somebody missing, if I'm watching a group that has great spacing and somebody's missing, I can tell. I can go, oh, well, that's a sick person, obviously, because their spacing's so good, you can tell. And that's not a problem. So don't use that as an excuse that maybe somebody was gone. Make sure that your spacing is clear throughout that. I would say heads up at the end, because you're saying a change is going to come. Oh, yes, it will. And then you went, and it didn't make sense. I know a heads down is kind of a cliche way to end a song. It's like, well, my heads are down now, so obviously we're done. but that doesn't match what the song is about. The song is about creating a new future, and change is going to happen, and we're going to make it happen. So the power has to be up and out. That change and that power is up at the top of the balcony. It's way off in the horizon. You got to be looking that way at the end of the song. Love Runs Out, again, good choreography style. I think the O section, the thing that happens before the claps, it's an opportunity to start something super soft there and just make sure that is gives you a chance to build. Because we do a lot in show choir of what I call mezzo nothing, which is we don't really ever get to forte, we don't ever really get to softs. Maybe we do it in rehearsal a few times, but when it comes time to performing, we kind of stay at the same level. So you know your show now, so now it's time to go back into it and go, where else can we build some dynamic range? And I think the O section before the claps, start that softer. And then continue to just look for those dynamic changes and those the feel parts of things. Vocally, Auburn always sings well, and I think that's there. I think we're at the point in the show where we've got to go back and dig into those vocals that I'm sure you learned really well before you started dancing, and now you go back and you build in that balance between sopranos and altos and the tenors and basses so that you can hear those chords happening and you're breathing and you're sending your sound out into the room.
Well, first of all, hello, Auburn. When I watched your tape, I was trying to see if any of you were on the trip that I, with Travel with Barb, when we went to Chicago, and with the masks on and the distance, I couldn't quite tell. So if you were on a trip with me, I say hello. Just a couple of things I want to say, and kind of back what Joel was saying. One of the things that I think the group is a small group, and when you have 50 people on stage, if there's a difference in sort of the level of commitment or level of comfortability with the choreography, it is kind of not as much of a factor because there's 50 people on stage, and we see the entire group and the energy comes out. But when you're a smaller group like Auburn is right now, you need to make sure that every individual is giving 100%. You have to all get up to that level, especially when you're spread out. We see the entire body, and the audience gets the entire picture. So it's just up to all of you to make sure that you up that energy and get your energy out into the audience and be really comfortable with all of the movements. Like Joel said, I think the whole show is there and you sing well, so get those things out. And I just want to, this is again what we would do if you were on stage with us at the very end of Change is going to come. That putting a head down at the end does kind of close off something, right? But I loved what Joel said about how it's a positive statement. Change is going to come, boom. It's kind of like the end of a speech thing when you say scene and we know that it's over, or you turn off the lights. But it sends a little bit different message. So you might experiment, and this is, if we were all on stage, I would try it and I might hate it. But more of an idea would maybe to be sweeping out and end up with it's the same thing if you grab at the end, but it ends up and leaves us with more of a positive than scene over and fade out, right? And those are kind of things that we can do on stage and try out, and then you can see, oh, I don't like that, or I like better, I want to keep it that way. But I would try it at least, take that idea of and make it that there's the goal and I'm going to get there. And it'll still, I think, get that same feeling across. But thanks for being involved, and I do hope that you'll come and be on stage with us next year. That would be great.